party put into jail a winning candidate, Imran Khan, still languishing in jail. You know, their members, despite winning election, still languishing in jail. You know, the army run Pakistan hijacked this, you know, an institution of democracy called elections. In Jammu and Kashmir, we are right now, while sitting here in front of UN, we are witnessing a very healthy election for the local government. We call it assembly election. First phase is over and more than 60% people voted. Now on 25th, we will have second phase coming. Even my district also will go on polls. So this is the difference between that country, which was created in the name of religion, and this country, which is there for last 5,000-6,000 years. You know, India is a country, most accommodative country in the world, like this beautiful country. Everybody comes here. You know, people treat us very nicely here. I love this country. This has become my second home. Similarly, people who were persecuted in Persia, Zoroastrians, they also came to India, living there, and we love them. We call them Parsi Indians. People who were persecuted in Pakistan, Hindus, Christians, Sikhs, they also came to India. Most of them are living in Jammu and Kashmir, our side of Jammu and Kashmir. They have been given citizenship. On the other side, people who migrated in 1947 to Pakistan are still being called as Muhajirs, migrants. So, very recently, I think in 2014 or 15, the people who were killed and persecuted in Myanmar, Burma, they are Muslims. They also came to India. Not a single Muslim country accommodated them. There are more than 50 Muslim countries. India gave them shelter. And they are living a very peaceful life in India. So this is the difference between India and Pakistan. Pakistan on one side is a crumbling society. And it's a failed state. Chaos everywhere. You see what is happening in Balochistan. You see what is happening in Gilgit-Baltistan. What is happening in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. People in POJK, they were asking for subsidy for electricity. You might have heard the one of the largest dams in Pakistan is in Muzaffarabad, Mangala Dam. And the people there are not being given that electricity. Similarly, in POGB, people have not been given any rights. They cannot vote and go to parliament. They cannot have representation in the Pakistani so-called parliament. But in India, the first prime minister of India was a Kashmiri. He was a Kashmiri Pandit, Jawaharlal Nehru. One Kashmiri leader even became home minister of India, Mufti Muhammad Sayyid. In Pakistan, a Kashmiri, living under illegal occupation is not even getting into the parliament of Pakistan. This is the difference. So this rhetoric, these propagandas have been there for last 3 decades. This is a failed attempt of Pakistan to actually divert the attention of international community from Balochistan. What Pakistan has been doing in POGB, Gilgit-Baltistan and POJK. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.